In this session that I spoke at today, we were looking for ways to detect what happens to different immunotherapies when given to you. Right now, you know that many people are doing research on new kinds of immunotherapies for cancer. The idea is, how do you re-educate your immune system to do a better job at fighting cancer cells? So to do that, whether it's through a drug, whether it's through an antibody drug, somehow you re-engineered the immune system to go find cancer cells. But the problem is, we have no way of knowing without imaging what your immune system is doing. For example, if I give you an immunotherapy right now, I don't know if that immunotherapy makes its way to your cancer cells. I don't know if it makes its way to your brain or to your lung or to your liver. By using molecular imaging, we can follow the immunotherapy at work. So in the talk today, I illustrated this using three different examples. One in which we take a kind of immunotherapy known as CAR T cells. These are T cells that have been re-engineered to go fight a tumor. What I showed was a way in which we can not only have the T cells fight a tumor, but a way in which we could genetically tag the T cells so that they could image and be imaged. That lets us know, did the T cells make it to the tumor? Did they engage with the tumor? And for the first time, as in the talk that I gave today, I showed the first human images where we're able to actually watch CAR T cells reaching brain tumors, thereby hopefully doing the next step, which is attacking the brain tumors. I also showed a couple of other examples in the talk today where we can image your immune system anywhere in your body by injecting in molecules that are these same spies that can go and find only activated T cells. So right now, if I inject a molecule into you, it might go to many different cells. But we've designed a special molecule that targets something called DGK and another molecule that targets something called OX40. Those two molecules, DGK and OX40, only exist in activated T cells. So when we inject our spy, it goes and finds those two molecules and therefore activated T cells. So in the work I showed, for the first time, after we're giving someone an immunotherapy, we've been able to image whether their immunotherapy is working. Right now, the only way you would know that is I'd give you the immunotherapy and wait weeks and weeks, months and months, only to figure out, did it actually reduce the tumor? But using these new imaging techniques, these molecular imaging techniques, we're able to tell within a few days after giving you an immunotherapy whether, in fact, the immunotherapy is working. That's important because if it's not working, we can switch you to a different immunotherapy. And if it is working, we can keep continuing the immunotherapy we're giving you, thereby not losing months of time to figure out if it was working or not.